What do people do when they get more money? They spend it. What do they spend it on? Most of us spend it in more than one house. Okay? So most Norwegians and Americans would like to get more money and spend it on houses. Okay? What happens if people get even more money? Do not spend it on alcohol. Or they go on holidays. So they go on holidays. So they buy a house so you can go on holiday. Just where that was in 2006 and 2006 and 2007. And most of it is Spain because they developed to this place where you can have comfort. Okay? So the answer is what happens if there is a financial, international financial crisis? People get less money. What happens if they have less money? And what will they cut their spending? Some of them can even pay for the houses more. What happens then? What happens in the house? What happens if many people have their houses at one time? And that creates a crisis. Because there are fewer people using less money in an economy that depends on more people and more money. If you want to have a guaranteed house right now, I can tell you a place to go. So if you want a guaranteed house, if you want to have a house, I should also say seven. But most importantly, in Spain, spending less money than you and the cost of that. So if you are a giant Spanish student, the chance to get a work is less than 50%. That's 55% of you in Spain will have a great work. And that creates the other problem. Is probably the unit. Some illness to this part of the world. Where do they go? The government, because they are aware that the kidneys are not enough. No one, no people, a scholar, no people using more money than there are fewer citizens. It's simply fewer giant companies that are going to be doing less production. Less production means less work. And the problem for the youth is they are not working. They can still work. They're not going to be able to do that. But they need to. So if it had been more critical to the cost of the economy, at least a new worker like this late. Coming into the economy, it has nothing to do. Nothing extra, nothing new. So the problem with the financial crisis is simply somebody has used too much money. But if you think it's too much, put it into their pockets and give it back to you. And the those of you who have bought money for nothing, not a good deal with guys from the law. You will know that the financial sector from 2007 increased their on paper profit from 70% of the total paper profit in the US to 43% in 2006. Where do they keep everything? According to money, for nothing. Not in It's too expensive to change that technology. behind the blue between two people. This man, Lord, why do I go do this, Lord? This is the cell phone I'm not able to use. So what I need to do now is go back to the screen. Okay? Then we are back to the status and credibility of the EMU system in the country. There was highly debated whether it should be or should not be. And we went into the public and got into the family land. The spirit and debate is the spirit of the system. But both sides have stories about it. Those against it is not. A group, those who were appalled is not. To rise or increase it if you are a member of the group and the group. The system of India has what we call four freedoms, called freedom of movement and the order. Easier to lose freedom if you have to stand up. So the basic idea is that the problem is the economic development of Romania compared to Germany and Sweden is a little bit different. You can do that. So there are very different regions now merging together into one system. That's what it looks like if you look at the US. When the US was introduced, both of the US was to the East Coast. The six original member states of the East Coast. The problem there was in the center and in the south. Some kind of south of the map. The people wanted to live in the sun belt. And there are also the businesses that they moved from east to west the area to the southwest. And we call it California. Must not be mixed with California Kingston, that is a different thing. So they moved from east to west. That's where the problem is now. But the problem is because that's what it comes now. We heard of a place called Detroit. Do you know what they call Detroit? What did they call Detroit? I think inside the city is not the country. That was the question then. I said, activities in the US have moved from that area to the southwest. So, within an economy like that, it could be the how many Romanians are allowed to go to the hospital in the Netherlands? Not too many. Because in the US, they could move freely. No one could stop them. Some would think in the US that it turned out to be that if you move industry from northeast, where they used to be possible, to the southwest, where it would be more possible, to get more equipment and more money, and to move from east. So if the economy is not expanding, what happens in the US is simply that we produce a peak in the southwest and more, so we get more money into the economy. But if the money is constant, that is what the impact is hoped, that it could cost the economy that people need it. You're because the ecosystem is not yet a stable system in the so therefore, the conclusion of proven when we need all the factor compensated, we need a closer political system right here. So it's one link, so it's not external, but internal. And that means that we no longer can arrange it with the context members. So we look at the leading cases that made the countries the U.S. is a federal state, So I think that's the main difference. It means that we live within a federal state system and live in the same state. To put it this way, I'm not a member, so it's not my problem to decide what to mean. Because you are within inside the U.S. But I think the conclusion given is completely clear. More political structures, but not structures. Thank you. We can go on with, now we have moved out of Spain and into the whole system. And we know it is very difficult. And we know the development is very difficult. But if the system works, there's more products, and more goods than money, or money we get. And if money is growing, more activities, more stuff, more activities that we pay. And those activities are not only money, it's done with money. So that is the basic idea. It should include the condition of production, make the goods cheaper, so more people can buy more goods for the same amount. In addition to produce more goods, they get even more money. So that is the basic idea. Did it work? And then I would say, come back in 15 years. Because just now, it's a mismatch between Germany and Romania. Because most Germans compare to Spain in Germany. And most Romans, or many Romans, prefer to Spain outside. Because it's not too much opportunity to get labor for employment in Romania, but in Germany. If the opportunity is in Germany, or in Romania, you have to move to Germany. So that is what it has one important effect, and this is for the notes. It was a potent thing for EU, they believe, yes, we can, but we can talk to EU. So what they decided was, we want one single currency. We got it in January. On January 1st, 1999, things that yes, we can. But what is what Barcelona's supporters said last night? Probably in a week we will know if they really could or not. So I think this is part of the EU or the Eurocode. We could, in 1999, avoid to keep off an amount that is coming from paying a tax. It is not easy. Too much money, too less values, or too less goods that we want to spend. You know the market is just to the border of Germany, not far from Belgium, and it is not really maximum. It's down south east in the market. It's a very small town. I've been there once. That's it. A very nice little town. Now, I came by train because I had a colleague, and a recent colleague working at the university. So that was the only excuse for going. It was a very nice little town in the Netherlands. and that taste of nectar. It was very highly aromatic. I think it was more than 100 liters. It was very in the mountainous area. I think they call it about New Jersey. So it's the only place I think where Maryland is really high. About if you could have seen. So this, I think this is the mountainous area. What is it with my food? Simply, I think it is from the borderlands of the context that we could need to discuss in the community. They came up with SGP. And we call it something very good. A very good word. The idea is what? You need to reduce inflation. So there will be an acceptable band of inflation that we expect. So if inflation is higher, then you have to take or you can take it. And there will be no appreciation of the exchange rate value. So no one that exists. There should be a limit to what we call public sector deficit. That's 3% of GDP. It goes to the same relative freedom of countries that get to get less money and could spend more money than all the others. Even if it could meet whether all the others are together. Who would have credit when we already have a big deficit of spending housing area, the housing building sector? They already were operating at the limit, but not as far it could be further as it needs to. I think they could be quite the country. They're losing the rest and getting let me talk all the dentists, probably not paying much, but pretty quickly. They do because they do a lot of money. So, yes, there was a deficit limit and a budget. If you look at from the health article, it took place, think you should be ministered. I think the deficit in some of the member state capitals was far less than about 2% already to be cut. Maybe the Germans are putting things up. So it was a general topic for all of the group. But they couldn't stand up to the obligation. And then what happens if you have a deficit that's already 10 years or 3%? Very soon, entering into long-term debt. We simply need to come up and pay the debt in free. We are going to loan to somebody the money. 50% of the spending of money, if it is run into deficit every year, we can be able to get it. A friend of mine has said, a million here and a million there and soon you got it for nothing. And so, a lot of debt that we do not have to pay back. We should have been kind of punished for it. We did get to the truth. So the system was allowed to go on without standing up for the state. It wanted a stability and growth that is SDP. But every time we see somebody, let's say in the football stadium, with an SDP, he's one of the commissioning members of the EU and the Peace Advisor, the first one of the two countries. So they have to cut the promise of this economy. These all of them should stabilize, low inflation, no public debt to vendor. Did that happen? No. The 11 countries voted in January 1999. Out of 50, 4 stayed out and didn't want to join. Probably the second last question from these three homeless of the country. Didn't deserve to call money, not the leader. 1999 out of 50, 11 out of 50. Start from down south. Three first number, three first number, three first number, four of them decided not to join. You can ask that, well, why did they want to join? And it's a very simple thing. But it didn't have any confidence in the system. It's like us supporting Bayern Munich. No, I mean, Barcelona, no, I go to Barcelona. We are not fully confident to take any money. So the best way to do it is simply, let's back on them, stay outside, and see the house, and the in Sweden and Denmark, trying to go into it. Do you want to go into it? Do they think they ever will? Because there are two new UK citizens that your political party that decided to take the time. Some of us would think it's about cutting their heads off. And what happens if people cut their heads off? So I think it's all the UK to do. What about Sweden and Denmark? I think there are many of us who say that the political problems that they would have in Norway if they went to Spain, but it's strong objections to their system. If the Europe is successful, think about this. Look at Europe and if it is successful, would you drop Swedish government and go into the system? What would then be successful? The system in itself has so far proved to be developed for the next 10 years. If it's not, it's successful for the next 10 years. So, yes, what is there? The EMU has got 6 new members, so now there are 17. What is the difference between ECB and ESB is one letter. What is that letter? ECB is in fact one bank in Europe, the European Central Bank. Is it the right to say it's the fact? Because in the EU, there is also an ESCB with 17 other central banks. The German central bank, French central bank, all the other ones are also in place in the economy. Does that sound like a unified system? It's very unified, isn't it? So, it is still a system that is still not believed in being a unified system. And that is also an answer to the question that if there will be a system, a monetary policy is the episode of those moments to come up and that quality comes up. And there's something else that opens banks to be set. That's something not a really great system. So this is your excuse me. So behind my argument is that we need a more unified system. If you are a football player, it's like having to have it open coaches to coach you every day. And I think if I was a football player, I would ask for 1 hour every day to have 18 hours to put one individual contact. Then I could live it. And that is what EU has done. So what I need is a pot that cuts the blood more than the other. So we have one, not 17 or 18. So if one unit is not qualifying, then we have only one and no sentence. So what? If this is an optimum currency for optimum currency level, because it's not. So the answer is probably if this is working as it is, it has to be completely broken. It has something that is not in position. So no doubt it has to be some of this. That is the success to employ all English citizens at once. I think 11% of my unemployed audience for that information. But sometimes it's 25. So, no, not fully successful, but we need a stabilization test. Has it been working? The question that came out. I think so far the answer is to some extent, not so. So there are issues that could be affected. How close are they into this? How much do they say creative? How much do you remain trade with Portugal? How much do Poland trade with Spain? It's a little bit bigger because they are two big economies. But if you compare Poland's trading with Luxembourg, they are not very big. That is problem with number one. Are they great partners? How many German companies cooperate with Portuguese companies when it comes to cosmetics? How close are the links between the former Yugoslavia state and the Netherlands? The only country that Norway has been close linked to very small of it is Romania. And if I look at the Norwegian, they are not certain why there is a close link between Norway and Romania. Good question. So the sign is built in Romania. How many ship vessels do they produce in Luxembourg? So if this is system with very big interest to come. So that includes a number, the other members. So therefore, who is more of a contact? We are not member of the close link to system. For instance, if we sell our cook to Denmark, or that you will remember the first week of this lecture. It's the closer number. It's what if somebody could hold, it is always to read my gun. To this we are closely to easy. Maybe we call the journey. And they have passed, we have. And so we link the time, because we need anything to live up to that. What did we say to Germany before the Spanish Inquisition? Yes. Pardon? And look. We have the link between the Norway and the country, before the Tiger and the Tiger. Well, so if this law, I think it's a very difficult to dictate by the truth. Or to get my two facts. My brother was one of a long brother. He conquered the first summit from Rome. Sometimes there were strikes in France. This would happen. This was the God. He was the priest. He said, we don't want this person. Not because they did my test, but they wanted to strike and put it. So, what we have told this is not a journey, but it is a fact. And then it comes and we need to be in the face of the group. Yes, so we have closer. We say a lot. Some of the countries, these are the most important points in the topics of law. We will then. When should we go in a fixed range routine? Where the range for exchange is simply very easy. We are certain that we get when we buy something in Europe. We know the price to get in the region when it's fixed. We don't want to read the newspaper and say, tonight the euro was devalued. Then it's fixed. But there is no problem. We need not have any problem to change it. We know that we pay. We know what we get. Two, we need no calculator. We have simply a calculator that is set 8.9, and then we pay every day. So, what I need is a very simple calculator to find out the difference. There's no transaction. I need a virtual bank to buy Danish coin and then convert that into the literature. But I don't need to do it. So that is your bank. And you know what an expensive paid link is? You know what intensive is? That is the feeling you have when friends tell you a story. There and then and just before. That is intensive. It's one thing at a time. Expensive is many things at a time. So we trade a lot of this. And we trade a lot of this. So that is expensive. So the difference is here. It's not only one, it's seven things. And it is a lot. Okay? Can move freely between two and one. And if you don't believe me, I send you this phone number. And if you speak Polish or any Baltic language, and you can find somebody nearby that you can speak, because they can move freely here to there. And probably you know that if you speak Swedish, you can speak some music. So, if you go out in Oslo to a restaurant or into a church where you buy newspaper, dinner, this is free. Because as a mighty freely from Swedish to North, we try to do the same labor market. So, we keep it a secret. Some of us call Oslo the biggest Swedish park attraction. And not any place in the world that has more Swedish as the culture of the country. Because it can be city. They just come here. Well, go back to Sabbath. And you see that way they don't go back to safety. And there's nothing to do with that. They believe because they can do something on their money. If they go back home, they have to stay with mother and father. And every time they want to go out to buy a beer, they didn't have to ask their mother, did I have 53 this corner? I need to go out to the city. If they're living out there, they can be fine. So it's a free movement between the two points. So yes, they can be very good reason to have a copy of the creation in this country. So, for those of you who have not read page 596, it's not very important as page 596, okay? So the most important thing in this chapter is on page 596. So if you have the strategy of reading these of the pages, here is the list. So, if there is a high degree of economic integration between the country and the city, it magnifies the monetary efficiency gains. In the system, when you have the old rate against this rate, it simply is easier to pay. You do more trading than participate. So this is the monetary system that allows you to do more trade easily than you do. It's like being Neymar. You are very good at playing football. So the best thing you do is play football. This is the area that is very easy to take. What do you do if it's easy to take? You play football. Some of us use that we cut them away against the ball. If you are better than Neymar, but it's a bit important to be important and the same. But it's easy to say when you say no. Why do they want a common currency rate? They want it to come in to be stable. More predictable cash flows. The bank decided to have the common rate. Is it worth the price? So far, I think we are coming. Did you do this? If you ask an unemployed Greek worker, I think the answer is no. If you ask a Swedish worker in Metro, I think the answer is there are a number of reasons. Still, we have problems. They need to be ready. So, yes or no depends on the participants you are. But I think so far I will be complete. And we are pretty close to why we do this process. It's simply because we can have stability in the monetary market, the customer is going to the real market. And what was the real market? Where they can be goods, services, that you can work, and that could be a problem if you're looking to be right now. Because they have monetary stability, and they have real stable economies from 25 to 75 years, if they are working for this country. This is like a real balances into monetary balances to the bank. So that is what we will spend the last 30 minutes to discuss. So if you want to do it now, or in the break. In the break. Decide it. See you in 15 minutes. 15 minutes.